That's why it'll never work. You have me suicidal.
Guys, welcome back to the channel. So in today's video, you know from you see me looking this crazy, it's going to be a makeup tutorial. So today's featured palette is going to be the ZuLu palette from Juvia's Place. Now this palette is retailed for about $14 and you can use anybody discount code that is on their page. Let's go over to their Instagram page. I have a lot of influencers that codes you can use to get like 10% off. Now this is how the palette looks. Very pretty colors. Now the colors that I'll be using today is this orange shade right here. Let me see if I can swatch it, show you this orange shade. I don't know if y'all can see that. This yellow shade, like yellows. I'm gonna be using the brown in my crease. I just swatch it on the orange, like seriously. The brown, and then I'm gonna be doing a cut crease with these two colors. The first thing that I would be doing is prepping my face. Now I use the e.l.f. oil control primer mist because I have really oily skin. No, I mean, you have a lot of good primers that are out there, but listen, I go for the cheap. As long as it works for me and it's cheap, it's the best thing, because makeup is expensive, I'm telling you. And this retail at Walmart, I think it was like $5.60. Or you can just go on their page, their e.l.f. website, and you probably get it like for $5 or something, but it's really cheap. I do recommend e.l.f. if you're just starting to do makeup and you need some of the products. Like, I recommend going to e.l.f. and Wet n Wild website and Juvia's Place for eyeshadow and Colourpop for eyeshadow. They're really good. So I'm just gonna spray this on my face and I'm just gonna rub this in. Listen, all this concealer craziness is gonna be going away soon, okay? So after I rub that in, this is my concealer that I use if I want to brighten my eyeshadow. So this is in the shade Rose. It's like a really light concealer, but you can use any eyeshadow base that's best for you. I just put a little on my eyelids just to prep my lids for my eyeshadow. I just take my beauty blender, don't mind the dirt, y'all females know how beauty blenders get, and I just tap this in just to prep my eyes for my eyeshadow. No guys, I'm not a professional makeup artist. I am teaching myself how to do makeup just like everybody else. For females that are just starting to do makeup, one of the advice that I can give to you is practice becomes perfect. I mean, you're not going to get your makeup, like some of the pictures that you see now, you know, with everybody faced all glam and dolled up, you're not going to get that perfect look all at once. You have to practice, and practice becomes perfect, okay? So now that I prep my face, I'm sorry, now that I prep my eyes for my eyeshadow, I'm just gonna go ahead and get started. Now with this eyeshadow palette, I mean, you can create a lot of looks. With me personally, I'm gonna be honest, I don't like to stray to bright colors because I don't think bright colors look good on me. But I mean, if I'm starting to go into this makeup thing, I don't think I will ever do makeup professionally. I just do it for fun because that's just one of my hobbies that I like to do, you know. So the first that I'm going to go in with is this orange shade right here. And I'm gonna go into the top of my brows. Sorry, eyelid. So I'm just gonna go ahead and I normally work from the outside in. As I stated in one of my videos, I don't think there is really a special technique to makeup. I think everybody just do their own thing and what works best for their face or how them think their makeup come out. I think that's what they go with. So that's just how I apply my eyeshadow. But apart from that, how is everybody doing? Y'all need to talk with me in the comment section. Tell me what type of videos you would want me to do. But being that Corona is going on in this world, how is everybody doing? How is everybody really doing? Right now, I am going crazy. I am sick of being home. I am sick of myself. That's pretty much it. I am running out of ideas what to do, basically. So, one day, like, me and my best friend got up and we said we're going to start doing this makeup thing where we post our makeup videos on Instagram, and then seeing the response that we got, we decided to we had a YouTube channel, but we just gave up on it. I just really was not feeling the YouTube thing anymore. But as my mom always said, I mean, you try something and you don't succeed, try again. You know, you're not going to get what you're looking for all at once. But y'all need to comment down below and tell me some ideas what you want to see me do in upcoming videos. One of the things that I don't like about yellow eyeshadows is that you have to keep going in continuously, because I don't know, for some reason it just takes a while to build the color up. Oh, so somebody asked me on Instagram if I can do a eyebrow tutorial. I'm gonna be very honest. I don't think I'm that good at eyebrows. I don't think I can do my eyebrow that good. But if a lot more people ask me to do it, then I'll attempt to do it. It's not a promise, but I will try. So I'm gonna do a little Q&A on myself in this video, because trust me, this is more than likely I was going to do a voiceover, but I felt like I had nothing to talk about. But you know, I'm telling myself maybe I need to, you know, open up a little bit more, try something different. And here I am, not knowing what to talk about. So I'm just gonna go in with this brown shade right here, and I'll be going in from my crease forward. So first question, what is my name? My name is Samantha. And my last name is White, like the color white. How old am I? I am 25 years old. I'm sorry, I'm 24. I'm turning 25 in December. Yes, go Sagittarius. What else about myself? My favorite shade of color is black. However, sometimes I will rock yellow because I just think it suits my skin color. Take a makeup wipe and I'm just gonna clean up the excess. Because right here is where I like to draw my wing. So I just go upwards and try to clean up a little bit. Alright guys, so guess what? I forgot to film the eyeshadow part of this look. But I'm gonna explain. So after I cut my crease with this concealer, I always try to use like a very bright concealer. I can use an eyeshadow base. I just think it brings out the color. Well, it is used to bring out the color a little bit more. So after I cut my crease with this, and if you guys want me to do a detailed video on how I cut the crease, then I will definitely do that for you. So after I cut my crease, I went in with this color right here. Let me show you the swatch of this color. So basically this is the green that I went in with, and I used a flat top brush and I just went in and lightly pat on it. So that's basically what I did for my cut crease, nothing special. And then I did do my wing off camera. What I used for my wing is this right here. This is the Sahara eyeliner from Juvia's Place. This is how the package looks. And I think this is retailed for $15, I think, $15.60. I think it's really worth the price because you basically get two eyeliners and a brush. So you get a double-sided angled brush, and then you get the black eyeliner, the black, and then you get the brown. So that's basically what I did, and I applied my lashes. So I will do another look and go more in detail how I got the look, but I just decided that I'm going to finish this video. So now what I'm gonna go in next is my foundation from Wet n Wild. This is in the shade Espresso. As I said before, you don't have to get expensive foundation. Just if you can find a brand that's cheap that works for you, then you can go ahead and do that. So this is in the shade Espresso and this retail for like $5. So I'm just gonna apply this all over my skin and then I'm gonna blend it out. This is the foundation brush that I used. I do recommend using a flat top brush. That's just what works for me best. You can get a foundation brush, but this, I don't recall what this is from. I don't remember the name, but this one is RT200 and it is a expert face brush. All right guys, so now that I finished blending my foundation, what I go into highlight is my ColourPop concealer. This is a really good concealer. This is in the shade dark 46. I think this this concealer retailed for about $8, I think, but I love it. One thing though, when it comes down to this, I don't really like to use a lot of concealer, so I just go in with a small amount. Then I'm just gonna take my beauty blender. I'm gonna blend. Now, the thing is, just the other day, I learned how to contour. No lie about that. And I still don't think I am very good at it. But trust me, nothing beats trial, okay? Nothing beats that. And if you fail after the first time, continue the second time. If you fail a second time, continue a third time. Let me tell you, this is when I just started doing makeup. I kid you not, I knew nothing about makeup. I didn't even know what a concealer was. And that is not even me capping. Like, I didn't know nothing about concealer. Like, when I was in college, I had a friend. I don't know if she want me to call her name, but I had a friend. Her name was Kiba, and she knew a lot about makeup at the time, because normally when she come to school, normally see her face and I would tell her that I love her face, and she always have her little makeup kit and her make with her stuff them in it and all of that. And I always said to her, like, what is this used for? What is that used for? And she usually laugh at me because it was actually funny. Like, I never knew nothing. The only thing I had for makeup was face powder, because, you know, going to school in a high school, and I was one of those girls, when school over, I go to the bathroom, go wash up my face and freshen up. That was just me. And when you wash your face and everything, we normally have a little face powder, and you just put on your face powder. That was it for me. So now after I finish blending out my concealer, I'm gonna go ahead with my Juvia's Place shade stick. Or you can see a foundation stick, and this is in the shade Katsina. See if you can see right here. See if I can focus. Nope. Okay. Yes, it's not working with me today. This is in the shade Katsina from Juvia's Place, and this is how it looks. Yeah, you got a pretty decent amount in it, so this is what I used for contouring. So I just go in with a little right here and I stop. Normally I would carry it all the way down here, but I realized that it does not go well with me. As I said, it was literally the other day I learned how to contour, and I'm still learning. So if you guys do have any recommendation, if you're good at makeup, you can, you know, comment down below and tell me some stuff what you think I should do. Now I go in with this flat, should I say flat top, like a kabuki flat top. Oh, it's a small stipper brush, okay, and this is from e.l.f. So this is what I normally use to blend my contour. As I said, I'm not a professional, so don't come for me. don't come for me. I'm still learning. So I'm gonna just go ahead and blend this right here. Okay, so after I finish taking my beauty blender and blending out my nose and everything, I go in with my loose powder. This is from Juvia's Place as well. Listen, y'all need to go over Juvia's Place and tell them to sponsor me. Tell them to sponsor me, because half of my products are from Juvia's Place, okay? But this is the loose powder. This is how it looks. It comes in a little container right here. This is called Gobi. This is how it looks. I think this is like a medium, loose palette. Loose powder. I think they do have a darker one. And I just go in with my little brush right here. This is how it shapes. I kind of like the shape of it. And then a dab in it. Kind of knock it off, because I don't like when it's too much. And I don't really bake. I just kind of tap it in. Okay, so after I finished setting my face with my loose powder, I go in with my contour palette. This is the powdered one from Black Radiance. This is a really good contour palette. So I just take a little bit and I just go back over what I did with the cream contour, just to brighten it up a little bit. Alright, so after I'm finished doing that, I do go in with my Maybelline Fit Me face powder. This is in the shade 360 Mocha. I think this is the matte poreless. And I take my big powdered brush. This is like a face brush, not powder brush, a big face brush, and I just go all over my face. Now for highlighting, what I do use is the glow kits from Anastasia Beverly Hills. Sometimes I will use my Juvia's Place if I want something a little bit more brighter. But for right now, this is like a subtle look for me. So I do go in with the shade called Bronze. Okay, so after I finished highlighting my face, I highlighted my cheekbones and my nose. I go in with my Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray. And listen, I go in with my setting sprays, okay? So let me just go ahead and set my face. Guys, so this is the end of this video. If you do like it, comment down below and let me know. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Hit that bell for post notifications so you will know when I post. And comment down below and give me ideas on what different kind of videos that you would like me to do. And don't forget, subscribe. Mwah!
Hey, too beautiful girl, that's why it'll never work. You have me suicidal, suicidal, when you say it's over.